It's a little bit of gold might.
See, doesn't that mountain look just like the
Salzburger
Knuckle? Salzburger Knuckle.
I like loud sounds and bright lights. They always make me laugh.
The scintillating discussion in the background. It's 9 o'clock. I don't know if you can hear the bells over the traffic. I could hear them a minute ago. We were saying yesterday they must have had fun planning all the Sound of Music scenes here, because there are just so many beautiful spots to film. Even spots that they didn't film in are so lovely. I wonder if there are any like deleted scenes or shots they tried but decided not to use. Although Athos was saying he hasn't seen Sound of Music, which I find hard to believe because we watched it in the house with you there.
I saw it when I was like 12.
When you were 12.
But, yeah.
We watched it just at Christmas time. I guess you weren't...
Do you remember me being in the room?
I guess not. And then on the plane, he could have watched Sound of Music.
I was
instead
watching
he watched
Shazam.
Shazam.
I couldn't help it.
Priorities.
Shazam.
Okay, this is a mini garden outside the Mirabell Gardens. We're in search of a conditorei. And then I think we're gonna get coffee at this place called Cafe Alchemy. And we're also gonna go look at those tractor loading stores as soon as they open. This is my trouble. You don't have to buy one. I'll just eat them all. Now that is not the dom we went into yesterday. I think that's another big church of Salzburg. The coffee place should be right up here. I got some kind of lattice apricot cream thing. Athos has a corn cream horn.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I was thinking how evil the man on my coffee cup looked, and then I realized I'm sitting next to a somewhat somber looking man. I like your coffee cup. D'Artagnan bravely ordered an iced coffee without even knowing exactly what it was. Athos, you enjoyed your macchiato?
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Pretty good?
Yeah, solid.
You look like you're giving this guy a side eye. All the blouses back here. Oh my gosh, that's so pretty. This. Oh my gosh. These are so beautiful. They're also, I think, 50% off, $640.
like her outfit. Look at that. Towers.
Do that again.
Look, everyone, it's one of the famous walls of Salzburg.
What did we do in Europe? What did I ask for a picture with?
The wall.
Look at it though, my dress is green. The wall is green.
See, this wall has actual stuff growing out of it. Oh, here's where we wait for the funicular. Wow. Oh, there comes the finica. That was certainly quick. Oh my gosh, look at how tiny the people look down there. Is that where the theater that they do in Sound of Music is? I think it's there's a theater set in the rock back there.
It is?
Yeah, remember where they when they escaped from the Nazis?
Yeah, there is.
Oh, and there are the catacombs. So that's St. Peter's. We had lunch around there yesterday. You can see the Alps in the distance. You're enjoying your top of Salzburg olive bread?
Exactly.
Oh, this is just bits of olive though, not like our...
No, it's not like the other one.
The full-on olive from Zurich. That was crazy. Here we are in the Hohensalzburg. We've got our audio guide. We're ready to start the tour. So this guy, see how his coat of arms is a turnip? Apparently we're gonna see that a lot all around the castle because he did a lot of building here at the fortress. This fortress was never taken by force, but it was surrendered to Napoleon. We skipped the torture room, but it looks like they just put some extra torture apparatus over here. So they were saying that there were salt mines near here, so the fortress was always well provided with salt. I didn't realize Salzburg, I'm pretty sure Salz means salt, right?
Yeah, it's salt.
That is so crazy. Wake up for an organ from the high fortress and see all the princes here. Until I think 1803, the city was controlled by archbishops. So when they say prince, they mean prince of the church. Although, wow, what about the Reformation? It didn't come to Salzburg, I guess?
Well, they said they used the dungeons to lock up Protestants.
So. Well, oh, with this fortress, Protestants aren't going to get far in Salzburg. That's why the cathedral's still Catholic.
It's a Catholic fortress.
Everybody who tried to take it, they just threw up in the in this castle. Oh my gosh.
Wake them up every morning with the organ.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, you didn't like the liturgical music? Listen to it.
St. George's Chapel. See, I now really want to find some turnip shields because they said they're all around the fortress. Oh, is one of those a turnip shield? I can't tell. Maybe not. Maybe so. Yes, I think that's a turnip. Look at that door. With the smaller door in it. Lots of cannons along here. Look, here's the turnip. There was such a cool film in that other room showing the different archbishops and like illustrating the different things they added. Whoa, those are huge. Those wine things over there. Yeah. Well, yeah, I suppose if you were sieged, you needed to have enough stuff stored up. My mom just asked if this had a turnip on it. It does. We were up there just earlier. This room is about Paracelsus. Was actually called Theophratus Bombatus von Hohenheim. Most people called him Paracelsus later. So hundreds of years ago, they hid these coins here in Hohensalzburg Fortress, but they forgot about them. And so they were only discovered during building work a couple years ago. Gosh, is that a picture perfect postcard view? Or what? All the towers. This is such a fun fortress. It's so neat to explore. You really get to go all around it. Oh my gosh, there are guys up on the roof. They must be doing work. Maybe they'll discover some new gold coins or some hidden hoard. Apparently there's been a fortress up there since Roman times, but then I think it was like the 700s or 800s that one of the archbishops built the first fortress, and then they kept adding to it and enlarging it. Did Leonard put a turnip in his furnace? I don't see one, but I wouldn't be surprised if there is one. It's like a whole armory for sale, helmets included. So there have been these little signs, and you can view these. Oh my gosh, this is when they built the first railway. Oh my gosh, that's so fun. Yeah, it's these little guys right here. You can scan them. There he is. And view the thing, that's so cool. We are not taking the funicular. We are going to attempt the walk back down to town. The smith sharpened up the weapons right next to the castle gate. That makes sense. He'd sharpen up the swords and then they could defend the castle. Wow, this is nice and cool in here. It's really steep, actually. My lord.
News from the front lines.
Except you should be speaking German. They wouldn't have had that word. That's airport. Whoa, check out this door. Is this not a wall of Europe if you've ever seen a wall of Europe? See, if it was snowy, we could just sled down this. Although that would be a difficult corner to bank.
It's like a slide.
That's pretty cool.
In case you're wondering whose castle it is, it belongs to Turnip Man. The third guarded archway. This is like Gondor.
Minas Tirith.
Minas Tirith. That's it. With the multiple levels. Although, how many levels are there at Minas Tirith? Seven?
Seven.
There are only four here. See, actually, if you were coming up this on a horse, it would be much easier. See, now this is a great wall to take a boat on.